Hey everybody, Alex from SeemsGoodMagic.com here, doing another playtest session with this deck. Just still trying to fine-tune it. The only change since the last video is we're going to try Impact Trimmers out of the sideboard. I don't think I want to main deck it, because there's probably some matchups where it's just not going to be quick enough, but I could see it actually being a pretty reasonable card against slower, control-y sort of decks. Not that we need more sideboard cards against it, but I just felt like there were some sideboard cards like Clash of Wills that probably just didn't really need to be in there. Probably have enough counterspells where we don't need them. So I'm willing to try it out against more control-centric decks. Everything else is the same, so we're just going to jump right into our first match. Okay, we're in round one here, and yeah, we'll keep this. Not the best hand, but Double Foundry actually makes this hand a little bit better, I think. Plus, we're on the draw. This hand could get a lot better. All right. Looks like probably Abzan. Wouldn't mind killing a Warden of the First Tree right away. Just get that one out of the way. Or a Seeker of the Way. Well, I guess we'll slash it. Not leaving up Negate. I think we can take a turn off from Negate. That's probably fine. Okay. Ruination Guide. Yeah, we're going to play that. Ruination Guide into Whirler Rogue is not too shabby. So now, if he plays a Gideon, we can actually go Whirler Rogue, make Ruination Guide unblockable, and attack into it, which is actually pretty good. Seed Drino, Woodland Wanderer. All right. Well, that's acceptable. Pia and Kirin Nalar versus Whirler Rogue. I think we want the Whirler Rogue so I can get in with the guide. Still feels like a winnable race, although it's going to be close. Oops. Secure the Waste. Okay. Take 7 or I think we're taking 7 here. All right. Wild Slash. He's tapped out. Guess I maybe wanted to play the Shivan Reef so I could have gone Wild Slash plus Pia and Kirin Nalar. Smashes back for 9 trample, which means I am going to have to block. Let's go Pia and Kirin. And this is interesting. So I can make Ruination Guide unblockable and get in for 7. Opponent cracks back. As long as I don't have another Seed Rhino, I should be okay. So I think we do make this unblockable with these. I think we get in with these dudes. We're going to have to do some chump blocking here, but I think this could work. Well, that would have killed us. Still a lot of things that kill us here, but if we can live, we're going to have to block with both guys. And we have to hope our opponent doesn't have, well, I guess anything. Okay. Got us. So we'll bring in the Disdainful Strokes. Bring these in. I think we can drop one Wild Slash probably. Maybe the Guide's slightly worse. Still like Aggregate for sure. Probably drop a mind. Well, Mindswipe could be good, actually, but definitely want the Disdainful Strokes. Is there anything else? I don't. Oh, Rose. Yeah, those would be pretty big. So bring in the Rose. I don't know if I want to. Do I want two negates? He killed us with creatures. He did have Abzan Charm, but certainly killed us with creatures. I might just want removal or creature counter, because I also have to stop the Wingmate Rock. Yeah, this could be better. Probably is better. All right. Could drop a Guide for another Mindswipe. Let's try this. Well, no, I got to drop a Guide anyway. All right, let's try this out. This time I want to keep the Wild Slashes in for that Warden of the First Tree. That got me pretty good last time. Yeah, we can keep this. We end up possibly taking some damage off the Sheevan Reef, but I think that's gonna have to be acceptable. We rip a land here and we're in pretty good shape. Alright, I will take Sheevan Reef. Going into Sky Spawner and possibly likely peeing Kirin Alar if I have to sack a Scion. Seeker, sure. Vile Aggregate, that's not a bad draw either. I still think we want to do. Well, he's going to get his third land. No, well. That's interesting, actually. I think we go. I guess we go Aggregate. My thinking is, if I rip a land, I can still go. This lets me block Seeker. And then if I rip a land, I can go Sky Spawner. Plus Disdainful Stroke, which is probably pretty good. Otherwise, I'll have to leave up Disdainful Stroke. I think we're going to block it. He could have Abzan Charm, but. Kind of just hoping he doesn't. Alright, no play is good news. So we want to rip a land here. Well, we did get the land, but not quite in the way I was hoping. So it's still okay. We get to go Cliffs, Equip Blade, and I think we do actually just get in for three here. So let's him crack back with Seeker, but I think it's worth it. Alright, so now we have Stroke up for important things, and we can still play Sky Spawner next turn as well as leave up stroke, which I think is pretty important. So this seems fine to me. Ooh, well, this is nice too. We still can't do Pia and leave up Disdainful Stroke, but we do get to go Sky Spawner and leave up Disdainful Stroke, which is pretty awesome. Plus, we don't even have to sack anything. Just got rid of a Wingmate Rock. That's nice. Let's equip to Sky Spawner here. We still get to leave up Disdainful Stroke. All right, block here. Forces him to make a play. Which I still think is okay, because we get to follow up next turn with Pia plus leave up Disdainful Stroke, which seems pretty good to me. Although we don't get to re-equip the Ghostfire Blade. Murderous Cut. Well, I think we stroke that. This way we can play Pia plus leave up and we can equip our this seems pretty good to me. Plus he doesn't have an attacker for Wingmate Rocks. I think the all in all this is gonna pan out quite nicely for us. All right. All right. Can't do anything about that. Anticipate. I guess we can do that first. Do have to take some damage for it, but I think it's okay. Sure. So now we go Sky Spawner. Pass. And the next turn we can go Ruination Guide plus Equip Blade, which seems pretty good. Okay. Not super intimidated by that. Whirler Rogue's good too. The question is, do we want to do Whirler Rogue or Ruination Guide? I think we go. Probably go. He can activate the Shambling Vent, so guess we go Rogue. Sets us up for a better Ruination Guide next turn. And think we just equip Sky Spawner for extra damage. Yeah, I guess we can make this unblockable. Because why not? He can attack us with Shambling Vents, but I don't think that's... It's likely not good enough. Okay. Guess he got us there. If his best play is Shambling Vent, I think we're okay. Painful Truths. All right. Got some value there. Take Air of the Wilds, because I can crack back for more. Looks like he's not interested. Seeker. Okay. I mean, we're in okay shape here, actually. So, can even go Guide plus... Do we have lethal? Let's go Guide. Equip Flyer. 6. Yeah, I think we're going for lethal here, so... Equip Flyer. It's 4, 6, 8. Yeah. Wait. No, I guess we can't. Oh, yeah. Yeah, we can. Play this. Make this guy unblockable. And then should be lethal there. All right. All right, beat the deck. This is definitely the deck to beat. It's pretty challenging. So he's got Radiant Flames, Murderous Cut, Painful Truths, Crackling Doom. All right, looks like negates are, in fact, pretty useful. Which tells me... What does it tell me? Maybe drop the Anticipates for the negates. I like what Anticipate does, but... Still think I would prefer the negates... At least a couple of them. They seem like important cards to have. Everything else probably is okay. We still have Digs, which I kind of like Anticipate with Digs just because you get to play mana early, get a card in your graveyard, and find other stuff while you're waiting to play Dig. But this seems fine to me. I think we'll probably try this again. This is a big matchup. I actually really like this matchup because it seems like the Abzan deck is going to be very popular. We're going to run into it a lot. So it seems like something I really want to be well prepared for. Yeah, we got to keep this hand. Aggregate into Whirlyrogue is very powerful. Opponent mulls down to 4 and keeps. Okay, well, if we were ever going to have an advantage... Let's say a mull to 4 is it. I guess the problem is the turn we get to Disdainful Stroke is the turn that I play aggregate, but that's okay. There's also a chance my opponent just does. I mean, my opponent has 2 lands in hand. Basically, I'm not really concerned because my opponent would have to have 4 drops as well as rip lands. So we're still on the aggregate Whirlyrogue plan, definitely. Just seems correct. All right. I mean, opponent's still doing really good. Definitely. The Air of the Wilds is certainly a problem. All right. I mean, we're going to block Seeker. I got to prevent some damage here. Another error, huh? All right. Well, that's okay, actually. Let's go Whirlyrogue. Make our aggregate unblockable. Although, I guess I can... Yeah, I guess we just keep everything at bay. That actually makes more sense to me. Because... we've got the long game plan going for us here. All right. I think we actually... Do I want to block with Whirlyrogue or the Doctors? Guess we block Whirlyrogue so my aggregate stays big. Makes more sense. All right. I mean, I don't know what to tell you. Opponent certainly had a pretty BA hand. Another Whirlyrogue? Sure. I guess so. But, I mean, this is where aggregate is supposed to shine. Okay. Ripped a land. Doesn't have a good attack. All right. I mean, now we're pretty safe. Yeah. Now we're definitely safe. We get to give death from above. We have counter spells. We have dig through time. Oh, I guess we don't have dig through time, but still do not think that opponent shouldn't win this. We've got a little bit too much good stuff to be in trouble here. He's got to get through layers of disdainful strokes and such. So just, I mean, I got to give opponent credit, though. They have really done well in terms of drawing. So he's got to gain the life. And I think opponent is going to be dead here because I guess we're actually one short. Oh, we're a little more than one short. All right. Okay, well, opponent mulled a four and did remarkably well. This just seems like a really... This is going to be a challenging matchup regardless. I think it's just a solid deck. So Vile Aggregate did its job here, though. It was able to stop Zed Rhino, but we're going to have some problems with our opponent playing Abzan. So that's just a matchup I'm going to want some more... Going to want some more practice with, definitely. And some suggestions on how to best defeat that deck would be super beneficial, because I'm sure some people possibly know better than I do. But all right, let's go to playtest round number 2.